You can hardly go anywhere in Houston without seeing construction. Experts say somewhere between 30 and 40,000 homes were damaged or destroyed after Hurricane Harvey, but there are not enough new construction workers to rebuild all these homes. According to a recent survey, 74% of Texas contractors are having a hard time filling hourly craft positions, such as drywall installers, carpenters, and electricians. The construction industry has long filled jobs with undocumented workers. The Pew Research Center estimated nearly 28% of the state's construction workforce is undocumented. Fear of deportation may be keeping them away.
Really what this business is about, it's managing people.
These Houston area high schoolers are in a special program, hoping to get ready for a career in the industry fast.
The good thing about this industry is it's easy to get into if you want to work hard, you want to work outside.
The students spend part of their school day shadowing construction workers. Their teacher, Zabero Hawk of Jones Futures Academy, says that many of his students are personally invested.
Majority of the students' parents are in the construction industry. Some of these students, by their sophomore or junior years, are on construction site with their parents.
And if they weren't already motivated by family ties.
We had severe impact by Harvey. I particularly have three students that have lost homes. I feel that there is more drive from these particular students because they want to better their conditions.
But determination alone is not enough to solve Houston's construction labor shortage.
They have an unsustainable craft workforce. There's more people leaving the industry than joining it.
Chuck Grimion of the Construction Career Collaborative is trying to get more people trained. He says Hurricane Harvey has made a troubling workforce situation even worse.
All this new reconstruction of homes that had been damaged by the flood and businesses that had been damaged by the flood, we were already working at full employment capacity to begin with. There's essentially no one to go do that work.
He says, historically, the construction industry relied on unions to train and develop a workforce.
Houston, back in the late 70s, early 80s, and before, was a union town. And unions provided all the craft training and the career paths in the construction industry. And then you get into the early 90s, the first company realized, well, I'll treat my employees as independent subcontractors. And when they did that, they cut out benefits, they cut out traditional state and federal employment taxes, such as Social Security, and they instantly had a 35% labor cost advantage when they were bidding work. And so today, much of the construction industry, I would say maybe as much as 80% of the construction industry, the construction trades in Houston are non-union or merit shop.
He says there's no quick fix that will suddenly bring more young people into the labor market. But the steady stream that the industry relies on, passing down trades through the generations, remains.
My dad taught me all the labor work.
Mario Morales got an initial push towards this career from family ties.
And believe me, he was not easy with me. Only his part of the reason that I'm still in the business.
Today, with nearly two decades of work under his belt, Mario is now working on a crucial task, generating more workers in the industry.
I currently have a brother here. He's 23 years old. So I don't cut him no slack either. I've trained him a lot, how to read drawings, how to read specs, how to read submittals. Sometimes I can see that he's overwhelmed, but it's for his own good.
And good for the city, because Houston has a lot of rebuilding to get done. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Tomeka Weatherspoon in Houston.